finally come full circle. The dictator is finally the orange. He's finally a czar.
But no, it's the exact pick the power.
Yeah, it is the exact opposite.
Oh shoot, I'm like right in the camera. Sorry guys, I'm just setting something up.
The champ, here we go. Bank rat versus pro rat.
It's like a 10 game.
It's a really good portal. All
right, hopefully we're going to get Yoon joining me on mic. Sorry, guys. No, I'm just listening to it. I don't actually want to listen to the whole thing. I just want
to...
No, we don't have good.
I don't have you updated, but we are recording and everything, so.
Okay. All right, here we go. We're about to get into grand finals. I'm Professor Roser on the mic from Bloomington. We're about to get.
See you, man.
All right, Amy, what's up, dude?
How's it going?
You don't have to lean in too much. They're good for you. All
right. So I'm assuming blue team is Pika Luigi, Bark and Shears.
Yes. Ooh. Yes, Pika Luigi. That's a good question. Because yes, the Luigi is the BDSM. So okay, this match already happened in Winners Finals.
Okay.
The stream wouldn't know, we wouldn't know maybe. But so Winners Finals went 3-2 to Bloomington, to the Bloomington boys.
Nice.
It was Mario Luigi for the first three games,
mm-hmm.
and it went 2-1 in Bloomington's favor.
Okay.
And then it was 1-1 after switching to Pika. So they did clutch it out game 5.
Right.
So we'll see. So, Bark and Shears have to bring this back 2 full sets against Bloomington in order to take this.
So right now, is that new team? So it's evened up right now.
Sorry.
I just gotta get situated. So Bark is the blue Pikachu.
Yes, Bark is the blue Pikachu.
Great
double up these Pikachus.
Oh! See, that's a danger. Pika just pop someone up, then Luigi can always just up the.
So Shears is really good at, like, kinda hunting for these up airs to get his up bees. And that's the advantage to Luigi in doubles. We are, as I mentioned briefly before, we are going Star King rule set in this, so you can't do, or SPK or whatever people call it. So you can only have one Pika or Kirby on your team.
Ooh. Now, I just want to point out, both teams actually did a great job of covering the edge. The Pikachu stayed last time, it was Shears.
That's an unfortunate death for Pikachu.
It's true. But what they're doing is they're doing one top and one bottom so that we can cover both recoveries.
Right.
It just seems like Bark and Shears are getting more of those conversions.
They're getting a lot more mileage. You can tell that they've... I mean, Beef and Dog Johnson play together a lot, but Bark and Shears have a lot of experience playing a lot of higher level matches against each other.
And you see there, I think it's David Beef just missing that edge guard, but you kind of have to when you're down like this. You know, just like
yeah,
that.
you have to go for it, you know.
Because both Mario and Pikachu, Luigi, they all recover so high, you know.
Right. And that is it for Dogs Johnson. So we have a lone Beef off the stage,
and
that'll be it for Shears. Yeah.
That's just another example of how Pikachu was holding the edge, and then the Luigi just came down. While Pikachu was still invincible, and they're just covering both options, so Mario didn't have anything to do.
Indeed. Why don't you put that up there? Yeah. Yeah, no, that's fine. Alright, so back into game 2. So that was a pretty commanding. Ooh, good up B, but you know, I'm not sure how much I like Shears using these up Bs before it's going to kill. Because
yes.
It does leave you in special fall afterwards. And it does a lot of damage, but maybe not as much as a combo might. So it's not like it's just giving so much damage that like it's always the best option.
It's been okay. It's been working out for Shears right now just because they're low percent. Both Mario and Pikachu can't really start combos with another Pikachu just there, you know, taking up space.
The dogs went off stage to get that kill on Shears. Oh, Bark
just
able to clean him up on that. And Shears able to get down fast enough. He prevents the edgeguard on Bark and gets the kill.
great recovery by Dodge, just kind of resetting that space.
Yeah, so a very even game right now. We have Dogs off stage. Ooh, edgeguard opportunity? No, but yeah, Shears was a little bit occupied. Beef doing a good job of being in the area. Really hard to focus wholly on edgeguarding in that case. Ooh,
Shears just missing.
Shears not happy about that either. You can audibly hear
it. Great edgeguard! Oh my god.
Dogs trying to play the tricky game and just fall onto that edge there, but Bark having none of it. Down tilt is not gonna. Let's see if Beef can get this kill on Shears. But meanwhile,
going for a strange just fireball. I think he was trying to cover if Mario were to go down the neutral or something.
Great job from Bloomington there. They not only did Beef get the edge guard on Shears, but Dogs was also putting the work in on Blue. That's it. Oh no!
Just terrible suicide.
SD for Dogs Johnson. Just didn't get the second one. This is an overclock console, so they shouldn't have too much issue with like lag messing that up. So that really was just kind of a mental error. Happens a lot. Dubs is really hectic.
Dogs again!
Dogs, he goes so deep, he meant to jump before he did that down air, but
sometimes it's really hard because you do have to reset that stick to neutral
and
before you make a direction.
That's probably going to be it for this game. Okay, so Shears does save Leaf for the play moment, but only for a little bit.
Oh, almost a great
save. Oh, no! Okay. That is a kill on Shears. If he can get a quick kill here on Bark, this is doable. I mean, Shears' Luigi is quite good, but, you know, Dogs could definitely bring this back. He's honing in on Bark right now. Yeah, he's again with Shears with the what? Dogs playing very well here. It is, you know, it's always...
great.
Luigi, the only character in the game with a better forward throw and a stronger forward throw than a back throw. And actually will take game two of this first set of grants.
And that's actually what kind of most characters have to do versus Pikachu, is you have to wait to see when they land. So Luigi has to grab as soon as Pikachu's landing, because just with the tier difference and like the different types of aerials that they have, you know, you had to be very careful against Pikachu.
Yeah, and the one thing I always want to point out, because everyone's always like, wow, you know, Dogs was doing so well in a 1v2 situation. Mm-hmm. It's always a little bit deceptive. You know, Dogs was really cleaning things up nice, but 1v2s are always kind of dangerous for the ones with the two, because, you know, they have everything to lose, mm-hmm. and you kind of have to avoid hitting your own teammate,
exactly.
Whereas the one player has the freedom to, you know, hit whoever they want. They can really just go at it. So, I love Dubs because there's always that possibility of a comeback. Everyone's like, is the comeback happening? Because like it actually is in some ways easier for the person who's won. Shears
always keeps going for that early up these as he keeps saying. You know, it's not really converting it into anything.
No, it's not that bad because like. Because of the way up B works with the Mario Bros, like it's not like that detrimental, but I do see him getting punished a little bit more, and we'll kind of see.
And we kind of noticed last game how he missed a lot of those just normal up B's that he used to do.
Correct.
So I don't know if he's kind of just building the habit, but just kind of trying to up B as quick as possible and missing. But
I think it's just, you know, he just goes for up B's. He's looking for the situation. Great edge guard for Beef there. Sorry, we lost picture for a little bit, so we were just kind of talking about general stuff.
You know, I don't know if that was great awareness by Dogs, but if you saw...
That fireball actually saved me.
Yeah, no. Dogs just kind of got in the way of Beef when he was thrown to kind of get that just extra projectile damage from there. Splash damage, and it kind of slowed down Beef's momentum. So that was intentional or not, but it was great awareness.
Okay. I thought... yeah, one interesting part of Dubs that there's actually some discussion about on Twitter recently, but it's not always best to save your teammate.
Exactly.
People always are like, oh yeah, like, go for that save was sick kind of thing. Like, it is a really, like, epic moment, but it's not always the best if it puts you in a really disadvantageous position.
Yeah, and sometimes it's better just to go for like a 2v1 situation, just hold off and keep yourself 100%.
Oh, see, that's a great
one.
That's great. Keith is already gone. Dogs is down to his last stock. Here we go. There's 2 minutes off the clock, and they lost all the 7 of their 8 stocks.
Almost a very, very good conversion.
Oh, wow. Oh, my goodness. But, you know, Bark able to pick up off that missed down B combo and just carry him off the edge into the Pika combo fashion.
You know, I think I'm starting to understand what Shears is doing with the up B's.
So bracket reset.
What he's been doing is kind of going in the thick of things. Usually, I wouldn't say approach with Luigi at all, just because, you know, he's very slow, aerial speed and things like that. But he's just kind of getting in between both Dogs and Beef and just getting, you know, like up B's, random smash attacks, and Bark would just come in and cover, which has been
very, very smart. Bark's been very solid.
And things like that, and then Shears can convert again with just like an up B, and it's been working very, very well.
So here's my question to you. What do you want to see from Beefy Dogs Johnson in the second set to try and reset things and bring it back?
Well, the thing is, both have been kind of just dying very, very quick, or they haven't been able to convert any edge guards. The past couple games, the past 2 games at least, they missed just about every, it wasn't free, but you know, you still have to
they have to convert at least more than 50% here. They're going to have a rough time, especially knowing that, especially single skill wise, they're not at the same level.
Exactly.
So they got to work much better as a team, in my opinion. Beef needs to, you know, he needs to be a much better sub.
Exactly.
As the Mario, he's really got to, like, kick it in the air. They have had a really good start to this game, so they're coming fresh. You know, they were already down 2 games in the first set of Grands. Like, sometimes you're like, look, it's okay to just, like lose this and whatever. Okay, Dogs does lose his stock. Okay, Beef waits it out, and
great
Dogs was able to get over there and help out Beef. And they put a lot of damage on.
Oh my god, very, very smart by Shears. Just kind of baited out that, just kind of edge guard, but then gets on
the B. Well, you know, he said, you know, screw waiting around for trying to grab ledge from Mario, which can always be so frustrating.
Exactly.
So up B, you call it a day. Pick you off the top of the screen. No spike, yeah. The spike is really hard to get, especially with someone who's aware of it, because you just basically have to knock the eye into the bottom.
Exactly. It's actually quite deceptive, though, because it has a slight, it kind of sucks you in, just very, very slightly, so you got a DI.
Oh, great edge guard from Dogs. Oh, see, they both kind of went to the ledge there to edge guard, and they, you know, we talked about it a little bit in the car. They need to do a better job of you know, the Pika needs to be on stage to cover stage, and the Mario should grab the edge.
Yes.
You know, a little bit, it's always sometimes hard to remember in the heat of the moment. You're like, get him. But,
and you know what I've been noticing a lot, actually, is he's usually a very capable Mario, but he has not been using any of his fireballs, you know? Have you seen the difference? Shears has been using a lot of those fireballs just to at least bait something to space things out.
Beef is also losing a lot of, like, close interactions with Shears. You know, both Mario Bros can up B out of things really quickly, but Shears is doing a great job of up being out of things and actually up being Beef. It's happened multiple times this game. It's really dangerous. Beef's got to be much more careful when he's in those combos against Shears to make sure he doesn't get hit. Yeah, great. Got him with the ramen noodles. Grab the ledge there. Okay, grab ledge. I don't like Dogs up being there. I mean, I guess he did it to avoid Shears, but that up B didn't leave him in a position where he could punish Bark.
Exactly.
And they really needed that kill.
And you see Beef again going for a very committed option when it wasn't safe at all. So it's just, he's got to get that awareness of when to do something safe, when to not, and take that risk.
Oh, and that is it for Dog Johnson. We'll have to see Beef as the lone Mario take this. So if he could get a kill on Bark and then get something quick on Shears, but it's not looking great. Oh!
I got a ball! Oh, baby!
Shears screaming.
Shears, of course, wanting the extra kill, not that it shows up on extra drives. Anyway,
is that 1-0 or 2?
That is game 1, so it is 1-0 in this bracket reset. So the momentum is real here. It really is bad sometimes when you when you're in winners. This actually happened to me at a weekly on Wednesday. You come from winners and then you get like either 3-0'd or 3-1'd.
Just because you're relaxed, you're not like warmed up.
And then you're
like,
oh,
that.
Shit. The momentum is not on my side right now. You are just not the one. You're not in control of the setting.
Yeah, the pressure honestly gets to you. It's pretty rough.
And that was my actual first interaction with that. I've never come from winners in grand finals before, but it did not work out well for me.
I beat Hipster.
I beat Hipster in winners, and then he 600
rounds. Yeah, it's okay.
All right, here we go. All righty. All
right, so.
Ooh. Shears, again, going for that early up B, you know.
Actually, I think that was very good because even if he didn't get it, he pushed Dogs off stage.
When he keeps him in shield.
Exactly.
Yeah.
So it allowed Bart to kind of just get back on stage, you know, edge guard maybe B or something like that.
I agree. I think, maybe we've been a little bit too crazy with these early up Bs. I think Shears is really catching them at times. So half of doubles, a big part of doubles is if your teammate has an advantageous position on one of the other teams, the other opponents, if you can occupy that player's teammate in any capacity, you're doing a great job.
You know,
so Shears doing that up B and keeping them in shield because they're stuck in that shield slide animation for so long, I think that really does a lot for Mark to be able to get a kill.
And you know, what I've been noticing actually a lot is another point to that is because they were low percentage, it almost seems like Shears is kind of baiting them out, you know, because he would get hit or punished with that, but because it's low percentage,
and he's getting it.
Yeah, Dogs, they keep going for up airs and things like that.
Oh, nice edge hits. Guard.
So what's happening is Shears is able to kind of get like a nair or a punish right after that. So
yeah, he's definitely using the floatiness of, I was about to say floatiness of Shears. Floatiness of Luigi. Oh, to his advantage, that's a kill. Wow, he's Bark is being super aggressive on the edge, making it really hard to really get to that ledge. Goodness.
Great dispersion by Beefs. No, but he just kind of baited enough and held enough time so that Shears could not recover. He just got too low.
What I'm seeing and why I think green stocks are just melting is like Bark is being extremely aggressive sort of in the ledge area, sort of off stage, making it just super hard to get to that invincible ledge spot, get back on stage, and then Shears is just waiting on stage. He's catching with, up airs every once in a while and then converting with the up Bs. So he's, like, it's extremely difficult to recover on these guys right now. Okay, so watch. There he is. He's off stage. Shears is ready right there. Okay. Commentary's cursed. Fair enough. Misses it. Misjudges it. Camera a bit wonky on him. This is... So Dogs. Okay. Oh, Beef has to do it by himself now. And it is not looking great. Shears is mad again if he misses that. As he will be every time
always.
He misses an up B.
Always. Do you see things like this though? Again, it's a 2v1, and you know, Beef is still choosing to do some up airs when they're lower percents.
Yeah.
So it can get percent on, he can only really afford to do that if the other Pikachu is there to kind of cover him. Green team,
just
needs to understand the hitboxes, the amount of hits they can do, and how Dogs can cover.
And you and I play.
Just, we got a couple games left.
Shears! Bold statement.
Shears calling him out saying, don't worry about singles, fam. We're about to close this thing right up in a 6-0 sweep.
He thinks he can talk trash to Midwest in the Midwest? Oh my god.
Go Midwest! Alright. So, we'll see. No! And that's a quick loss of the stock for Ooey indeed, Dasty. Quick loss of stock for Dogs. I know Dogs are happy about that. Oh, there goes B too. Shears just going out there threatening. Ooh. And now, here's the thing. Now, like, playing with a lead with this type of team, Shears can be, like, so passive-aggressive and, like, go for just up Bs at random points, all this stuff. They do get a team kill there, so props to Bark for getting an extra.
Just pointing something out. So Bark did a forward smash that actually killed Shears,
yes.
But it's actually sometimes a good strategy if, you know, Shears had great TI, could do stage TI. Bark would able to just edge guard and kind of save Shears at the same time, but you know, that conversion not really working out. But it's just something to know if you trust your partner, you know.
Agreed, yeah, and sometimes it's worth it.
Exactly. Shears is very high percent. Try something new.
Well, but that's what I said right before. You know, going with a lead, especially, but now they don't have a lead anymore.
Exactly.
Pretty well done for Dogs and Wolf to bring this back.
Ooh.
Oh, okay.
Oh, my
saved
goodness.
By Bark there. Bark just didn't know that Shears was going for that. He wasn't watching. I don't blame him. He was going for beef.
Exactly.
Okay, both of them off stage now. Oh, and a great coverage from Shears. Great read for the top lat.
Very, very smart from Beef. Just knowing when, you know, the ledge invincibility would kind of run out.
Oh.
Survive.
Okay, Shears is way off stage. But they're not going to be able to get there. Bark doing a great job of just, like, keeping both of them active. Just being Bark Sanchez, you know. Okay. Alright, yeah, Shears fishing a little bit too much for these up airs right now. They're not at a good percent. Maybe Dogs is, but...
No, but that's what I'm saying, too, is I think that Shears has kind of put some fear into him. Because you see him kind of approaching a lot.
Oh, great edgeguard from Beef.
After
there.
I say that, he just...
Yeah, alright. Commentator's curse.
Exactly.
But, no, I agree with what you're saying. Okay. Good attempt from Beef to try and save him out of the grab. Shears smartly just waiting out the hit, using his throw invincibility.
And I just want to know, Beef kind of saving
here. This is tournament stock. I just want to point out this is tournament stock for both green team players.
But
they
got Bark. Okay.
Okay. So now it's
2v1.
The 2v1. That dangerous 2v1 I was talking about. It's difficult to not run into your teammate. Now, Beef and Dogs do have a lot of chemistry with each other. They play together all the time. They won the last Mom's Dogs tournament, so they're no strangers to working together. They're also no strangers to getting comebacked on in 2v1s. Peep the Outfox set against the insults as a but anyway. Okay.
Yeah!
That's it. And animated. Okay, Bark.
Going for something
when you're Bark
very,
Sanchez.
Very high risk, but no punish there.
So here's the thing. If Beef can get an up air, there's a lot.
Ooh!
And that's a poor trade.
Great,
GameStop
great
trades
game.
Out here.
Great
Let's
game.
Go. Game for Bloomington. And to come back after that 8-second
exactly.
Dogs SD, my word.
And, you know, Bark actually said this to me one time, but sometimes you save certain things, certain mix-ups for the very last games when you kind of need it.
Yeah, and that's
and
brutal.
That's what Beef kind of did. He used his down B to kind of get out of a situation.
That Mom's logo is incredible. He turns up and down.
Yeah, but kind of that up, down B kind of works like a shine because it comes out very, very quick. And it kind of will mess up their position, and that's what it did. And it kind of set them up for a good edge guard situation.
This game started game 4.
Because it's 2-1. Yes, sir.
We're good. We're up. Okay, so starting out. Both. Okay. Great read from Bark. Could Beef make it back? Oh no!
Oh.
But he's too far off stage. I didn't realize.
What a conversion! What a conversion! Oh my
great
God.
Job from Beefy Dog Johnson. They took that stock to both stocks. I didn't realize Beef still had his jump. He was able to jump into that nair.
I
survived. Okay, again. Shears again going for that up. I don't like that time for an up even if he had hit it. It sort of took him out of it, left him Bark all by himself. Not that Bark can't handle himself, but you know, it's.
But still, you have to respect
concept.
Doubles.
You have. At this point, they've already lost a best of 5 set to them. They've lost a game here. You know, they could lose this tournament. You have to respect the Dogs.
Exactly.
Okay? Oh! great on Bark to interrupt that team's killer.
You know, and that's another time when Beef kind of just has to understand when he should sweet spot. Because he kind of just didn't respect Bark, and Bark just punished.
Yeah.
You know?
Playing it a little bit too safe.
Turn on stage.
Okay, upbeat, yes. Alright. Ooh, and that is a rough turnaround for Green Team. They're gonna come down here with double invincibility, double high percent. So let's see, can they. Both of them are offstage on the same side.
Ooh, just missed a time there.
Todd's playing too much melee. They can get Shears.
Great
on Shears. He's just been hanging onto the ledge for the last like 40 seconds.
Exactly.
And he got a kill and he stays alive.
Wow.
That could be the 40 seconds of the tournament. And Bark is now going
to back throw there. I don't really know about that. Maybe just one of the extra percent on the back throw.
I'm not sure. Can't speculate. Alright, so. Okay, they'll be. No? Deciding on something. Okay, that.
Someone is dead. We can
be it.
Yeah, wow.
Deciding not to take dogs as stock, I disagree.
You know, I don't know. I kind of respect it. I think that Pikachu works better in a 2v1. Just because Mario just has such
a time. Okay, you're down 4 stocks. You've got to get both teammates on the screen to give yourself a chance.
It's true.
The chances of him making this comeback are so low, even if he has 2 stocks. I mean, I get that he's doing a lot of work on the stock, so maybe I'm wrong.
He has a chance.
If I eat my words, I'm more than happy to use it. I still don't think it's the right thing. Okay.
Oh, getting the
if he would have gone the other way.
Oh, great
man. Oh, if he could also back throw.
Cheers!
No!
Oh my god.
Oh! Shears reaching for the handshake.
We just talked about Shears awareness and he didn't even know about the stocks.
Yeah, he's out of it. Yeah, you know, while Shears, you know what he should have done?
This might. This is.
Oh, the Bark Sanchez to end.
The Bark Sanchez to end. Great double smash.
All right, well.